Let's get back to the action on the field. And this is the seventh play of this drive.
Ball at midfield.
The home team come out on a nickel package. Dropping back. Throws it. And the catch is made. Number 81 did a nice job tracking that ball down.
You know, he did a nice job of putting that pass where only his receiver could make that catch.
Eighth play of this drive.
5 yards to go.
This team has to start converting on third down if they're going to be successful.
Gets the pass off. That incomplete pass will bring up fourth down. Ninth play of this drive. Well, if the defense can stop him one more time, they'll get it back. Tosses it right. Stiff arm to the ground. Big hit on the ball carrier.
And when you talk about getting unloaded on, that's what happened here. He just got unloaded on.
First and 10. The quarterback lines up with two backs behind him. Can't bring him down. Number 20. Couldn't find any room on that one.
They really hustle on the defensive side of the ball. They're very good at clogging up the line, limiting the number of holes and cutback lanes at the back has to choose from.
It's second down and a long way to go. The quarterback gets set with only one back behind him. Again, he'll get the call. Drop behind the line for a loss of a couple. Number 20. Didn't have much to work with on that running play.
That's because the defense did a good job anticipating the snap count. With an aggressive defense like this, a hard count could be an effective way to keep him off balance while trying to draw him offside.
The Hawks come out in a dime package. Gets the call again. Seymour makes the play at the 35-yard line. Well, that didn't cut it. Now they're looking at fourth down.
And they made the decision to just keep it on the ground. Take time off the clock, not force anything. This is a luxury of being ahead.
Nothing happening on that drive, and they'll punt it away. Here's the punt. From the 28-yard line. And the offense getting ready to come back on the field after a decent return. So they have first and 10 here. Number 22, the lone back. Gonzalez goes in motion. Gets the toss to the left. He's brought down behind the line for a short pass. So after that run, we can see how the two main threats on the ground have fared so far. It's second down and a long way to go. The home team come out in a nickel package. Incomplete pass. That incomplete pass will bring up third down. Only one man in the backfield. Calling an audible. Throws it. Perfect pass. Gamble makes the tackle at the 47. He flings that pass right to his receiver.
That quarterback rarely throws a bad ball.
So they have first and 10 here. Come out of the nickel. He'll pass on first down. Nowhere to go. Good play in the backfield.
Number 60.
Right after the quarterback from his defensive end spot.
And a sack really helps in the game of field position. It puts him in a long yardage situation. And that gives the advantage to the defense.
Fifth play of this drive.
The ball is right at midfield.
Come on, let's go.
Slings it to the outside.
Number 43
stops him at the 49-yard line. Appeared to be a hold on that play.
Some of these guys wear jerseys two sizes too small, or they tape them to their pads to prevent that kind of thing.
So we'll have a second and long after the penalty. Dimebacks into this play. With the pass, and it's caught. Manning seems to put every throw right on the numbers.
I'll tell you, of all the quarterbacks in the league, he might be the most accurate. It seems like just about every throw is a good one. He's not the kind of guy who's going to throw a lot of balls into coverage either.
The home team come out in a dime package. Throws it incomplete. Number 59 made a great defensive play, tipping the pass away.
Well, that's just the kind of play they've come to expect from him. He always seems to make the big play just when they need him to.
2-minute warning coming up. Looks like he's calling an audible. Gets rid of it. This one falls incomplete. They go for it and end up turning it over on downs.
In this type of situation, the team needs to try anything they can to get into the end zone. This time, they fell short.
Almost at the 2-minute mark now. They'll go from the I formation. On the ball. Trailer got very good penetration there. Couldn't find any success in the middle.
And the thing is, that's where it all starts, with alignment. And whoever can take control and dominate in the trenches is going to have a huge advantage over their opponent.
2-minute warning coming up. Number 20 is the deep back. Mangum, the man in motion. They have to get to the 36 to convert for a first down. Number 20. Bullwick records the tackle at the 45-yard line. Short gain on that burst through the middle, maybe half a yard.
I don't think I'd call that run a burst. That was more of a limp up the middle. I'm guessing this should be a run. The defense can't be lollygagging around. Because if they are and they give up a first, this one's over.
Hawks come out on a nickel package. Number 20. Number 20. Couldn't pick up any blocking on that play.
The defense is always very aggressive when defending the run. They're extremely disciplined. And they get off their blocks very quickly. Makes it tough to find openings when you're running the ball.
Number 22. We'll try to improve upon those numbers on this punt return. The punter heads in for the fifth time. Here's the kick. He signals for a fair catch. The defense is trying to force a turnover, which would put an end to this game right now. First and 10. He sees something in the defense. He's looking. Throws on the run. Nearly intercepted. Time is working against them.
Yeah, I'm thinking they're going to keep going to the air, but it might be a little too late.
Only one man in the backfield. Manning with a man in motion.
Come on.
drops back, closing in, fumbled. The home team. He's lost another fumble, John.
Well, after he lost that first one, you can see that he's paying more attention to the ball. But still, he let it happen again.
This one is just about in the book. They need 11 yards to get it into the end zone. Number 20, the deep man. Number 6, with a man in motion. Number 39, and he just got level.
Yeah, you know that whole deal about what happens when an unstoppable force meets an immovable object? Well, the unstoppable force won that one.
They're 8 yards from the end zone. The quarterback lines up with two backs behind him. Hand off to the tailback. Bland brings him down at the 5-yard line. And he picks up about 4. Five more yards to get it into the end zone. Number 6, out of the gun. To the end zone. Incomplete. Good defense down near the goal line.
The defensive coordinator believes in the bend but don't break philosophy. They give up some yardage in the middle of the field. When they get down near the goal line, they really turn it on and make big plays like that.
We should see a field goal attempt on this fourth down as they'll try to put some more points on the board, adding to the lead. John Casey will attempt this field goal from about 22 yards away. And it's up. No doubt about that one. What a shift in this one. 20 unanswered points for them.
They're just pouring it on. They're really starting to dominate.
As we take a look at his success returning kicks, we get ready for the kickoff. Kickoff team lines up. Booming kick downfield. No return this time, and the offense heads out into the field, taking over at the 20.
Any run plays in the playbook should be thrown out because they need points fast, and the only way they're going to get them is by throwing the ball.
So they have first and 10 here. Changing the play now. Dropping back, looking for an option. He was hit just as he threw. And they have to go to the air because they need big plays fast.
That's right. You got to have composure in these situations. Find your receivers who can pick up yardage after the catch. But most importantly, you have to keep the chains moving. Okay, they got to keep throwing downfield to move the chain while keeping the clock movement to a minimum.
The quarterback is back in the shotgun. Rolls right. Gets the pass off. He hits his receiver. Johnny has great touch.
Now you say, what's his strength? What does he do best? Well, you can see it right there. It's his accuracy that puts this guy on a whole nother level.
They'll pass on every play from here on out.
When you're down by more than one score and there's less than a minute left, that's all you can really do.
First and 10. He sees something in the defense. Dropping back to pass on first down. Passes left. He hits his receiver. They get another first down here.
Well, they're not doing anything fancy, but good old-fashioned drop back and pass, and it's working.
Time is running out. They'll have to keep the ball in the air. It's first and 10. They line up in the I formation. Play here on first down. Slings it over the middle. Incomplete. No choice here, John. They just have to keep throwing.
Yeah, they do. Running the ball isn't going to do a whole lot of good now.
This is the fifth play of this drive. Changing the play now. Manning sends a man in motion. Dropping back, throws it, gets his hand on it. The incomplete pass brings up third down. It's third down here. They have to put points on the board very quickly and then hope to recover an onside kick. And this is the sixth play of this drive. Manning looking to pass, lines up with five wide receivers. The incomplete pass brings up fourth down.
There's no need to go for it here when you're down by this much. The last thing you want to do is get one of your starters hurt. They'll probably just punt.
This punter has been out there all day long. I guarantee you he's loose. Here's the punt. And he waves for the fair catch. They'll come out running here to wind the clock down. Inside their own 20. Number six sends a man in motion. With the carry. Solid hit. Just crunched it.
The thing is, when you get hit like that, it's like having a bumblebee in your helmet. You just can't get rid of it.
He doesn't have blazing speed, but he'll just run you over if he has to.
He'll come out of the backfield and make a few catches, too, if you forget about it.
So this could be the last play of the game. We've come to the end of this one, and the score is 20-0. For John Madden, Jill Arrington, and the folks at EA Sports, this is Al Michaels.